A skydiver has noticed that he has fallen 264 feet so far, but forgot to set his timer. For how much time has he been falling? Okay, now a free-falling object, and that's what we're modeling here, we're neglecting wind resistance, follows this function. Height as a function of time is negative 16 times t squared plus h sub 0. Now in this case, it's been falling 264 feet and for 4 seconds. So this output, h sub t, is actually 264. And the input t, well, we don't know. And h0, well, we don't know that either. So, you know, the question is, well, how do you solve this? I mean, all you know is that after so much time, he's fallen 264 feet. Well, let me get a calculator. We'll try graphing it and see if that makes more sense. So I'm going to put negative 16 x squared. I'm going to use x instead of t for the input variable, but I'll just remember that x represents time. And then let me just go ahead and graph that. Okay, so here we can see a parabola, and this is assuming an initial height of 0. And this could apply if you're at the top of a canyon and you throw something in and your relative height, let's say that the top of the canyon you call 0, and then everything below you would be negative. Well, we're not really sure what the initial height is, but what if we use 264 as the initial height, and that'll measure our 264 feet, you know, just the same way. I mean, it's not exactly 100% model, but it should work for what we're doing here. Let me graph that. Okay, really it just looks like two vertical lines, and all that tells me is I know I have a quadratic function that should be a parabola, but the window doesn't fit. So how do you adjust the window? Well, 264 feet, that is the initial height, so that should be the maximum. So let me go to window, and I need to change the y max, that's the maximum height. Let me put 300, and then graph that. Okay, that's a much better looking representation. So the deal is, okay, here's your skydiver, initial jump out of the plane, and you could ignore the left half of the parabola here, that doesn't apply. So that's outside of the domain of what we're talking about. So initial jump, and then 264 feet, that would be right here, from your initial height of 264 feet down to zero. And you know that the skydiver jumped from higher than 264 feet because they wouldn't be hitting the ground here. But we just want to know how much time passes 264 feet. So see, it looks like 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me look at the table of values. Well, it's not exactly 4. You see how 4 you would have a value of 8. So we'll have to approach this a different way. Well, let me get back to the graph. What I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate the x-intercept, because that would mean at 4 seconds, because that would mean at 264 feet, we would know the exact amount of time. So the left bound, I need to be the left of the zero, which I am. Then I'm going to go to the right of the zero, which also puts me below the x-axis. Okay, so it's 4.06 or about 4.1 seconds. Okay, so let's just recap the process. Kind of stuck here as far as what to do. We knew the 264 feet was the distance fallen. So what we did is we used that as the initial height for this H0. And then after 264 feet, that would be at the x-axis, where the output would equal 0. So then we used negative 16 t squared plus 264 equals H0. And then all we did is we calculated the x-intercept, and so we found that the input of 4.1 seconds would give you an output of 264. So that's how we found out the 4.1 seconds for the time.